قرآني قرآني في قلبي دوما يغمرني. The last two verses of Surah Al-Baqarah, these are so beautiful verses, subhanAllah. They are super phenomenal, extremely beautiful, and I'm sure most of us must have memorized these verses because it's actually a dua, right? لا يكلف الله نفسا إلا وسعها لها ما كسبت وعليها ما اكتسبت ربنا لا تؤاخذنا إن نسينا أو أخطأنا. And so many virtues actually that have been mentioned and recorded from the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam regarding these two verses. One of the best virtues is what the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, as narrated by Imam al-Bukhari, an authentic narration. من قرأ آيتين من سورة البقرة كفتا. Whosoever will read the last two verses of Surah al-Baqarah, it is sufficient for him. What does that mean? It is sufficient for him from every evil. When you read this every night, no evil will come close to you. Whatever evil you can think about, even in the wildest of your imaginations, what you don't think, but it is evil, it will not get to you. Because this is what the Prophet ﷺ said. So these are very beautiful verses, but we actually do not know the reason behind its revelation. A beautiful story that I want to share with you. So Imam Ahmad, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala be pleased with him, in his collection, he records that Mujahid, one of the close students of Ibn Abbas, the master of tafsir, said to Ibn Abbas, I was with Ibn Umar radiallahu ta'ala anhu, and he was reciting the last verses of Surah Al-Baqarah, and all of a sudden I saw him crying profusely. Ibn Abbas radiallahu ta'ala anhu said, which verses are those, Mujahid? So Mujahid said, he was reciting لِلَّهِ مَا فِي السَّمَاوَاتِ وَمَا فِي الْأَرْضِ, the third last verse of Surah Al-Baqarah.
لِلَّهِ مَا فِي السَّمَاوَاتِ وَمَا فِي الْأَرْضِ وَإِن تُبْدُوا مَا فِي أَنفُسِكُمْ أَوْ تُخْفُوهُ يُحَاسِبْكُمْ بِهِ اللَّهِ.
To Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala belongs whatever is in the heavens and whatever is on earth. وَإِن تُبْدُوا مَا فِي أَنفُسِكُمْ, if you reveal what is in your heart, or you conceal them, or you hide them away. No, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will call you to account for them. You will be held accountable for whatever is in your heart and in your thoughts. Allahu Akbar. So Ibn Abbas radiallahu ta'ala anhu said, yes, when this verse was revealed, the third last verse of Surah Al-Baqarah, of the end of Surah Al-Baqarah, it was extremely heavy upon the companions of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and when they understood the extent of its implications, they came rushing to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam and they said, Ya Rasulullah, this is a very heavy verse. I mean, we thought that we are accountable for our external, our outward statements and actions, what I say, what I do, what I commit. But our inward actions, what passes in my mind as a moving thought, as a passing trivial thought, what is in my heart, I mean, we don't have control over that, Ya Rasulullah. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam did not like this. And he said to them, do you want to be like the two nations, the two nations of scriptures before you, the referring to the Christians and the Jews, do you want to be like them? Whenever a verse was revealed, an instruction of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala was revealed, they said, سَمِعْنَا وَعَصَيْنَا. We have heard, listened, and we disobey. We choose to disobey. Are you going to be like them, or are you going to say, سَمِعْنَا وَأَطَعْنَا, we have heard, and we have complied and abided? They all said in unison, سَمِعْنَا وَأَطَعْنَا غُفْرَانَكَ رَبَّنَا وَإِلَيْكَ الْمَصِيرِ. We have heard and we have obeyed and complied. غُفْرَانَك, your mercy we seek, O Allah, and to you we shall return. When they said this, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala revealed the last two verses of Surah Al-Baqarah as a reprieve for them. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says,
آمَنَ الرَّسُولُ بِمَا أُنزِلَ إِلَيْهِ مِنْ رَبِّهِ وَالْمُؤْمِنُونَ. The messenger has believed fully in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and so have the companions, the believers, right? All of us, we have believed. Kullun amana billah. All of them have accepted the instructions and commandments and abided by it. They have believed in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the books and the messengers. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala revealed the last verse.
La yukallifu Allahu nafsan illa wus'aha.
Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala does not burden the soul more than what it can bear. He doesn't command us to do that which is beyond our ability and reach. Right? So the companions, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said to them, this verse has abrogated you, the previous verse which you had a concern about. Now, the passing thoughts, whatever is in your hearts, as long as it's not a determination, it doesn't reach the level of it being a determination, a firm resolve, you will not be held accountable, because we don't have control over that. As long as you do not act upon it and you do not remove it and make it into a statement. Once whatever is in the heart, you put it out, you had a doubt about someone, you cast aspersions against him and you stated it, or you felt evil about something, there's a passing thought in your heart and then you acted upon it, right? Then you will be held accountable. But as long as it's a passing thought, no sense.
لا يكلف الله نفسا إلا وسعها.
Allah will not bear us more than what we can hold, more than what we can bear.
لها ما كسبت وعليها ما اكتسبت.
Yes, you will be held accountable for your sins. وعليها ما اكتسبت, and you will have, وعليها ما اكتسبت, you will be held accountable for your sins. لها ما كسبت, and whatever you did good, you will be rewarded for it.
رَبَّنَا لَا تُؤَاخِذْنَا إِن نَسِيْنَا أَوْ أَخْطَأْنَا.
They made this dua. Oh Allah, don't hold us accountable in نَسِيْنَا, if we forget, أَوْ أَخْطَأْنَا, or we do something accidentally. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, I've heard and I've accepted.
رَبَّنَا وَلَا تَحْمِلْ عَلَيْنَا إِصْرًا كَمَا حَمَلْتَهُ عَلَى الَّذِينَ مِن قَبْلِنَا.
Don't place upon us as a nation the burden that you placed upon the previous nations. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, I've heard and I've accepted.
وَلَا تُحَمِّلْنَا مَا لَا طَاقَةَ لَنَا بِهِ.
And don't burden us with what we can't bear, what we can't have a strength over. Allah said, I've accepted and I've heard your prayers. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, then the verse concludes,
وَلَا تُحَمِّلْنَا مَا لَا طَاقَةَ لَنَا بِهِ.
وَاعْفُ عَنَّا. Forgive us. وَغْفِرْ لَنَا. Pardon us and overlook our sins. وَرْحَمْنَا. Have mercy on us. أَنْتَ مَوْلَانَا. You are our master. أَنْتَ مَوْلَانَا. فَانْصُرْنَا عَلَى الْقَوْمِ الْكَافِرِينَ. And aid and assist us against the disbelievers. What a beautiful, what a beautiful verse. Memorize this dua if you haven't. والكون الواسع في صدري.